Thank you. Alt. Sorry, can you hear me? Hello, 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 testing. Test, test. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Featuring the Platinum Band. And this time, whoa, it's a little dark in here. Hold on. Stream phone, stream phone, stream phone. I'm going. I'm going, I'm going, I'm going. Unplug hair straightener. Join alternate channel. Excuse me, ferret. Maya. Okay. Go back. Chat connected. Hello. Okay, we should be good to go. It's a little dark. Is it a little dark? Do you think it's dark?
Pickle-pong. Wow.
It's too high.
96 all skills resubbed for 27 months. Alerts pause champ.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. How's that? Is that better? Should we do it like that? And then why is this on? It's on auto, but it doesn't look dark.
People pug, wow.
PM one resubbed for 9 months. My new girl Loki hates UXD.
That's too low, isn't it? You shouldn't sub to me if your girl doesn't like me. I don't like that. That's weird of you. Is that okay? Is this too bright?
Delegates resubbed for 2 months. People pop, wow.
Black dot. That? Is that not on my monitor? That was on my monitor.
People pug, wow.
McKinbar is up for 5 months. Maya Heal.
It's my fridge.
People pug, wow.
A2020 Civic C resubbed for 7 months. Maya, do you have any tips for humanely trapping mice that snuck into your house?
Don't use glue traps.
People pug, wow.
Spherix was up for 26 months. I stole Puyaman's new girl.
People pug, wow.
39 Gatos was up for 2 months. Hello friends, love you all, Maya Heal.
Change the lens so it might have to take off the lens and put air on sensor.
Sour
Yair is up
for 15 months.
I'm not taking
off smile.
That lens. Why is it not? Is it
Evangeline 2400?
Is it focused right now?
Is up for 11 months.
People pug, wow.
Super Dew Preg is up for 19 months.
Flip!
The new girl.
People pug, wow.
Matip 4 is up for 10 months. Good morning. This jail cell looks remarkably like your tiny house.
Oh my god.
Imgen 100 resubbed for 22 months. Maya each year.
People pug, wow.
InfSim 0N resubbed for 5 months. Maya each year.
People pug, wow.
Oh god.
NG2K resubbed for 9 months. Rat alert.
Where's the focus settings? Excuse me? Focus mode. Manual focus, continuous, automatic.
H9 resubbed for 19 months. Smiley face.
Is it not focused or do I just not have my glasses on? I know there's a black dot on the lens. Here's the deal, folks. This is gonna be our friend today. All right, because I'm not taking the lens off.
Pastel Max 13. Resubbed for 3 months. I think we should just deal with the black dot, name it, and have it be a new ambassador.
That's what I'm saying.
Also, how are the marmosets doing? Less than 3.
Dottie! The marmosets are great. So, focused or no? Good. Focused enough. I usually move this because it takes up a bunch of space. Okay. What do you think? Good enough? Now I can't unsee the dot. Good. Turn off autofocus? Huh? You want me to put it in manual focus? That seems like a bad idea. Log Spirit, thank you for the 10. I'm so sorry. I have not been reading out subs. I've been trying to figure out this camera. All right, I'll take it off of autofocus, but I'm a little bit scared. Fats, Pastel, Rebecca, Edgy, thank you guys for the subs. All right, I'll put it on manual focus, but I think it's usually on autofocus, so that seems like a bad idea. But here, it's on manual now. What the heck? What the heck? Didn't change anything? Excellent. Great. Please get out. I need to put these away. Mushroom.
SC4R3 Crow is up for 7 months.
Thank you for the 7 months. Autofocus isn't freaking out anymore. Okay, that's good. Oh my god. Ow. Okay, what are we thinking now? Wilkes, SC, Log Spirit, thank you so much. Is everything okay? Is everybody feeling okay? Good? Good? Yes? Excellent. Why won't you take off the lens? Because I don't want to frick it up. And I don't think it's that big of a deal. And I would rather have a little tiny black friend here on the lens than not have a camera that works. And I've never taken the lens off this camera, and so I don't want to test it while I'm live. You feel me? It's annoying. It's only annoying because you're thinking about it, okay? In the same way that you only feel sad because you think about being sad. Just don't think about it. Okay? Don't worry. You'll be just fine. Of course. Just, yes. Here, I just won't stand in front of it. Then you won't even notice. It just blends in.
It's my birthday.
Happy birthday! The sauce! Happy birthday! Okay, nice nails. Guys. Did I talk about this on my stream or just... I think it was just the Alvea stream. I'm actually really excited about it. I was gonna do them on stream. But then I was like, no, they're gonna get so bored because they're guys. But I will say, I did my makeup on stream like once and it actually went pretty well. Like, I didn't lose people. So maybe I could do my nails on stream. But, look at this. Oh, it's on manual focus. Well, no, you can see them. Oh, Look. I did these. Cool, right? So, I did them the other night. I know no one cares. It took me 2.5 hours, but when I go into the salon, it takes me 1.5 hours, and the salon is 30 minutes away. So it takes me at least 2 hours to get it done in the salon. So it's not that bad, and it was my first time doing it, so I had to like read the instructions and stuff, but I'm gonna get way faster. Second, I can make them whatever shape I want. I don't just have to make them whatever shape until I feel like I'm asking for too much when they ask if I still want it changed. Because after saying something twice, I'm just like, no, that's great. You know, because I don't want to be annoying. So, like, I can make them, like, I really like when they're more narrow. Like, see how they're, like, really narrow at the tips? I like when they're that narrow, but then when they do my nails, they make them really square. And then I'm like, can they be narrower? And they make them, like, a tiny little bit narrower, but I want them way more narrow, but I don't want to tell them. Thank you for the 21 months. So I like, I can make them whatever shape I want and I don't have to feel bad about it. Also, I can make them whatever color I want, and if I don't like the color, I don't have to panic for 1 hour internally while I'm watching it happen to my nails. I can just change the color. Also, here's the kicker. When I get my nails done, it costs $75 in the salon, and I bought, or Turka ordered all the stuff so I could do my nails at home, and everything to do them cost, like, everything that we bought to do them at home cost $70. And there's enough in the kits that I bought to do 50 sets of nails. So my manicures went from $75 to being 71 cents. Each. The margins in nail salons are crazy. Crazy. I do like the nail tech. I wouldn't say that she's my friend.
Found 221 resubbed for 6 months. Is this a Thursday singing stream? Can you sing All I Want or the Star Spangled Banner next?
The Star Spangled Banner? Are you doing acrylic or press-on? These are poly gel. So it's like, you have a fake tip and you put this gel underneath this gel glue, and then you put the tip on and you cure it.
Robo underscore resubbed for 3 months.
Thank you for the 3 months, Karobo. So I'm more worried about being able to get them off than I am worried about them falling off. They're pretty. Kelpie, I read you like a gray name and I was like, God, is it that bad? Is the dot pissing people off that much? I barely even notice it on my screen. This is way overexposed. I should turn this down, right? I should go auto. This is it on auto, but now it looks dark. Does it look dark? Or is that fine?
Wow.
What the hell?
Mel Bell resubbed for 14 months. 14 months, Bogu.
Wow.
Space, that makes no sense. All I did was turn the ISO down. That makes no sense. Hey. That's so bizarre. I'm sorry, he's gone. Adam and Mel Bell and Spence, thank you for the subs. Is that a dot on the potty pad or is that poop? That's poop. One of them pooped. It was on cam. You go back in the VOD.
Now I can't unsee the dots.
Okay, this is mostly stuff that I was just bringing back from Caleb with a C's. That's why it's in this bag. Streamer, did you see the isopod shed yesterday? No. Did it happen on camera? We have a grocery haul this morning, by the way. It's been a minute. Except this is all, don't worry about this. This is already, this is not like new groceries. It's just my stuff. How much did you spend? So, this grocery trip, I try to spend $100 or less on my meal prep groceries, but this week I did half of the shopping at Whole Foods, half of the shopping at HEB, and I had to get some staples. Like, I ran out of salt last week, and I got some snacks to prep as well. So it ended up being, I think, 160 instead of 100. I'm sorry about your predictions. But last week, I only spent 70. So it's not that bad.
HAS underscore X to 3M3 result for 9 months.
Thank you for the 9 months. Okay, here's what I brought back from Caleb's apartment. My cornstarch. These are new. I bought berries for today. My sesame oil, my rice vinegar, and I bought these actually. This is grilled mango in syrup. And this is from, I grilled at his place before, and so I brought back some of the grilled veggies. So that's obviously not new. And a potato. Yay. Potato. So there's that. I think I bought two potatoes yesterday. Thank you. It is very nice and cozy in here. Miss Dawn, thank you. So, now for the actual grocery haul. Let's see. Okay, this is crazy. I bought these because of my niece. I don't like not having automatic focus. Can I turn it back on? Let's see. Maybe if the, because the ISO has changed, maybe it'll be fine now. Maybe it'll be fine now. Let's find out. Okay, so I got these. I'm gonna cry. Focus right now. Okay. So this is their, it's their baby snacks. Baby snacks. My niece eats these. She's a baby. You have a lav? Okay. What, did I just get really loud? I don't even feel like I was talking that loud. Whatever. I'm sorry. I can turn it down. Do you want me to turn it down? It clipped. Should I turn it down? I didn't feel like I was that loud. No, it's fine. Okay. Okay, so I got these baby snacks because my niece eats them and they're actually really good. So I'm excited about that. Okay, then I got some old-fashioned rolled oats because I'm gonna make overnight oats again. I'm gonna give them another shot. I love the, being a Californian Gen Z liberal, I really love the idea of overnight oats. And I just feel like I would like them if I could just get it right. So I'm gonna keep trying. And then I got, I don't wanna label myself, but No, yeah, that's accurate. I got oat milk. Yeah, that's accurate. I got vanilla oat milk. Excellent. I got a baguette. Really? That's crazy. How'd you get one? I feel like they're so hard to get right now. I'm so excited for you. What color is it? I got vegetable broth. I got fortune pay me. You should have asked for a referral. Just I don't even know how to do that. I got two onions. I got a red onion and I got a yellow onion. What happens when I get a red onion, Chad? What do you think I'm gonna make with that? And then I got sliced sweet pimentos in oil. They're just like peppers. Pickled onions! I'm gonna make some pickled onions. We don't get paper bags around here that often. You wanna go in the paper bag? Fun. Wicked. Moonstone, thank you for the sub. Presley. Oh, that was the Ford Maverick guy. Okay, so I got all this stuff. Then. These are reusable plastic bags. Pomegranate, lemon. Ooh, sea salt. This is flaky salt. I'm really excited. I wanted flaky salt, but I haven't gotten it because I wanted to run out of my salt. Now that I ran out of my salt, I can use flaky salt. Snacks. Stroop waffles. Okay. For the overnight oats. This is why it ended up being more than $100 because I got a bunch of this like extra stuff. Normally I just get what I'm making for the meal prep stream. So I got flax seed. I figure with my overnight oats, I have. Oh no, honey. God, I just sounded like my mother when I said that, but I'm talking about literal honey. I have chia seeds. I have these chia seeds to put in the oats, but then I saw this flax seed. And I remembered that I gave Acero flax in college. We give horses flax to keep their coats really shiny. So I imagine that it's good for your hair and nails. So I wanted to get it for that reason. And then on top of that, I am looking for more protein. And there's 3 grams of protein and 2 tablespoons of this. There's 3 grams of protein and 2 tablespoons of chia seeds. And I need a bunch of protein because I don't eat that much meat. So I'm thinking more protein, more fiber between this and the chia seeds, and then more, or maybe that it'll be good for my hair and nails. I don't know. Rhyme. Can I help you, Russell? Where is he? Thanks, Russell. You too. Hey. Stay. All right. So that's what I have there. I also brought these back, don't worry about this. I need this to pickle onions, it's apple cider vinegar, and this is just seasoning sauce for some Asian food, but that was mine before. Walnuts, also expensive. Walnut halves to mix with the baby food, baby snacks, and to put on top of the oats. More protein, more fats. I got chickpeas. I got sliced olives. Another potato. This kind of pasta. Fusilli. Okay, one more bag. didn't get a lot of veggies this trip, but I did get a ton of fruits. Mushrooms and cherry tomatoes. Oh my gosh, I'm really excited about this. I've never seen figs in a grocery store, but I found figs. I love figs. And I want to see if any of our animals like figs because they were a huge hit at the zoo that I used to work at. So I'm going to see if our ambassadors like them, so they'll get to try those probably today. This is my favorite fruit in the world. Do you guys know what this is? Persimmons! Yeah, they're Fuji persimmons. Alright. Then I got some vanilla Greek yogurt. I got mozzarella pearls. And I got two slices of brie. Kind of all over the place today. But that is all. I have no clue what she's making. Yeah, do y'all have any guesses? It's a bit all over the place today. No. Pickled onions, yeah. I meant to check. Oh, I forgot I got that. Stupid. Stupid. Oh my god, I have so much yogurt. What have I done? I forgot I bought this yogurt last week. And I have this yogurt. And I thought that it was expired, but I have until the 28th to eat it. Shit. What am I gonna do with all the yogurt? Okay, I have a lot of yogurt. Okay, pasta, granola, yogurt bowl, pickled onion, or overnight oats. Okay. Yes. So, what am I making today? This is for one thing. This is for another thing. With this. Oh, and this. And then this. So for this, I'm gonna prep baked brie. So I'm gonna put this in foil with some sliced figs and walnuts and honey, and I'm gonna cover the foil up, put it in the fridge, and then when I want baked brie, I'm gonna bake it off in the oven and then slice bread. So there's like a baked brie situation. That's what, number one. Number two, pasta salad. So this is for the dressing. And then this all goes in the pasta. So these all go in the pasta salad. This goes in the pasta salad. This is the pasta. And then I'm going to make pickled onions that go in there as well. And then all of this is overnight oats. Oats, chia seeds, flax, walnuts, fruit, yogurt, oat milk. And then, if I want to get crazy, I'm thinking, because these are all very, like, fruity, like, not heavy things. I was thinking about making mashed potatoes with like a mushroom gravy in case I want to eat something a little more heavy. So we'll see. I have until 3 p.m., so we'll just see how we do on time, and if it's feeling like that is something that makes sense to do, which I think it does, because these are just like, most of this is just like prep, like it's not gonna take that long. So we'll do that. This is all, these are all dishes from the Nut House that are clean. So I'm gonna put these away. Do you think that I should just mix the flax with the chia seeds? Any real food? What do you mean, like a steak? Something like that? I don't have any of that. Sorry. Where's the steak and potatoes? I do have potatoes. Is that sourdough? Yeah. I think. No, it's just a French baguette. No water yet. Bruce is making music now? I should also prep a couple more smoothie bowls. I'm gonna prep the overnight oats first just to get it all out of the way because I have so much stuff on my tabletop right now. I'm also gonna start cooking the pasta because that'll take a bit. Please fix your calendar. Look what I got. January. Saved. Gnome Child, thank you for the sub. TARDIS Nerd, thank you. Gnome Child, thank you for the bread. I'm not saying that in reference to the money that he just gave me by subbing. Am I getting this right, or do I have you mixed up with someone? Gnome Child met up with Connor and then sent us like dessert bread. We've been eating it. It's in the Nut House. It's really good. I really like the strawberry cream cheese one. Thank you for that. Okay, so I'm gonna prep three overnight oats. I'll show you how I plan on that. Ow! The fact that my nail didn't just break there is actually an excellent sign. I just dropped the glass thing, it like clipped my nail and it hurt, but it's fine. Asks for food. Russell, if you want to come all the way out here, you are welcome to the food that I make today. But I'm not coming to you. Okay. So. Okay, on my way. Great. Andy, thank you for the sub. PCV, thank you. Overnight oats. Easy enough. You have to use old-fashioned rolled oats for overnight oats. You can't use the instant oats because they don't soak up everything the way they're supposed to. Okay, so there's the oats. Here's the chia seeds. Have you made overnight oats that you've liked yet? No. chia seeds. My problem is, like, I just have a really hard time eating cold oats. Like, I need them to be hot. Otherwise, they just taste gross to me. But I've never tried to put yogurt in them. Okay, this is flax. I've never had it before. Smells like horse feed. I don't know. Just put it in there. Flax is terrible. Really? You can reheat them? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. I probably will end up doing that. Okay. I'm leaving it. I'm amazed your ferrets are still playing in the bag. The reason, please. A lot of calories in those seeds. Yeah, for their size, it's a lot of calories and a lot of protein and a lot of fiber. Real underscore chopper subbed for 9 months. Hello. Okay, this is oat milk. It expires February 21st. Because last week I had to buy whole milk and it expires the 18th, I'm going to put whole milk in these so that I can use this milk. Normally, I would put oat milk in there, but this week I want to use this. So we'll do whole milk. I usually just like cover it and that's enough. Because they soak up quite a bit. Okay. And then this is plain Greek yogurt. I also would use vanilla Greek yogurt if I didn't have to use this plain yogurt up that I do. Ding, 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 ding. Yogurt. Just a scoop. Plain, no vanilla. This is vanilla. This is my plain yogurt that I have to use.
Wow.
Danny Bird Greeter is subbed for 20 months. Yo.
Okay. So much yogurt. God. Can I make something with... Chat, what can I make with yogurt if I have, like, insane quantities of yogurt? I want more matcha. Matcha hack. Frozen yogurt. Smoothies. Put it in a smoothie, curry. I could try to make yogurt bark. Yeah, I'll do that today. I don't like yogurt in a savory context. I've never been into that. Okay, we're gonna do a little honey. Sweetener. Messy. I made a mistake on this one. No! Why didn't you tell me? Is a regular honey squirt bottle more practical? Absolutely, but look at this jar.
X underscore free resubbed for 13 months.
Like, are you kidding? X-Free, thank you for the 13 months. Danny Dirt Great, thank you for the 20 months. Style over function. Yep. Okay, do a little mixy mix. Stepping in honey. This doesn't really want a mixy mix. See, I already am like feeling like I don't want to eat this. No mason jar for overnight oats. My mason jars are too deep. Like, it's hard to eat with a spoon out of them. Mixy mix. Mixy mix. Didn't I say I was gonna start this pasta and then I just didn't? Big water expense here, folks. Why not add the yogurt and honey before reheating? Do you think I can't microwave this for like 30 seconds if there's yogurt in it? Is that a bad thing to do? Do I have to eat this cold now? Have I made a mistake? Oh no. Seems fine. I actually don't know. If you microwave yogurt, it makes eggs. Okay, you are talking out of your ass. That is not true. That doesn't make any sense. Are you trying to say that it like curdles and it makes like scrambled egg consistency? It's factual. If you microwave yogurt, it makes cheese. Alright, I'm done listening to y'all. You can microwave yogurt? I feel like if you can bake with yogurt, like you can bake some things with yogurt, can you not? So I feel like you should be able to microwave yogurt. Right? Yeah? Alright, I don't know. Okay, so I have raspberries, I have blueberries, and I have blackberries. Take some of each of these. Rinse them. Put them in here. My grandpa always microwaved yogurt with cereal for breakfast. Saved. Grandpa knows best. Okay, I'm gonna microwave it then, and I think it's gonna be fine. So sad. No, so sad. I'm eating these. It's fine. Nobody worry. Everything's gonna be okay. Drop count 3. Okay. Alright, last one. Chat, raspberries, blueberries, or blackberries? Fuck, marry, kill. Fuck all three. Okay. Blueberries if they're properly ripe. Blackberries, blueberries, raspberries. Personally, if anyone's wondering, I would like to give myself a little bit of pesticide to eat because I want to eat it. I don't want to wash them again. I'm tired, okay? Had a long morning. Personally, I would marry blueberries for sure. I would probably fuck a raspberry just because it's the most practical, and I would kill blackberries. I think I'm the only one using my brain here. You guys aren't thinking hard enough. But organic. Common misconception, merge. Pasta. Organic doesn't mean they don't use pesticides. Organic just means that they use only certain pesticides that are approved by the FDA. So they use different pesticides than conventional ag. But sometimes they do use more, but they are supposed to be better for the environment. Don't let me forget that this pasta is going. My sea salt. This is exciting. This is exciting. Okay, people. Check this out. Pesticides add flavor. Is there free-range fruits? No. Sea salt. Flaky sea salt. Refill day. Yum. Don't get weird. Just a little. Just a little. Don't get weird about this either. That's only for topping dishes. Salt is salt. Okay, it's just shaped a little differently. It's a salt! Better salt the pasta water. Last but not least, into my overnight oats. You can fucking tell what it is. It's walnuts. I don't know why I didn't focus. Welcome to the Salty Spittoon. How tough are ya? So, in these overnight oats, I will take out the fruits and walnuts from the side, microwave the oats, put the fruits and walnuts into the oats, and then eat it. And I will let you know if I like them. But I am skeptical. We'll see. Number one. These are kind of heavy. Jeesh. It's going to put me over 100 pounds for sure. Alrighty. Wait, I have stories to tell. I went to court this morning. I almost went to jail, AMA. No, I really did go to court this morning.
Wow.
Axial Mars just gifted 10 tier 1 subs.
Axial Mars, thank you for the 10 gifted subs. Thank you so much. Ella texted couldn't find the trough this morning and sent a picture of the water trough, like, in the bushes. X4K gifted a tier 1 sub to Aggregate. Thank you. And said, Connor's like, OMG, Kayla said she is unbelievable. And Ella said she left dried boogers in it and everything. It's Winnie. Winnie moves the trough at night. She's like a little... Nightshell, thank you for the 5. She's like a little elf on a shelf. She pushes it around with her boogie nose. Hides it in the morning. What a rascal. So, I went to court this morning. Why did I go to court? Because I got pulled over because I had a broken taillight. I got a warning for the broken taillight. And then she's like, how long have you lived in Texas? And I was like, oh, like a year. because I still have a California license, which I'm not supposed to have. And then she went and like scanned my license. And she was like, you've been here for a lot longer than a year. You're supposed to switch to a Texas license. You're supposed to switch to a Texas license within 30 days of moving to Texas. And unfortunately, thank you for the 17 months. Unfortunately, I got a ticket in Texas around the same place a year and a half ago. So she was like, you need to get a Texas license. And she gave me a ticket for it, a citation. So I had to go to court. So I was like, ready to go. Hold on, I want to make a snack jar. Or should I make okay, this is what I'm gonna do. Yeah, this is what I'm gonna do. Okay, make a snack jar. So on my ticket it said that I'm eating baby snacks. Yes. These are organic Yogi's banana mango for baby. Melts in baby's mouth. Oh, they're so good. They're so good. It tastes like yogurt and bananas and mangoes. I want to mix this better than I'm going to be able to in the jar. Yeah, let's use a fucking strainer. Smart. So you can't choke on them? Yeah. They just melt in your mouth. Delicious. These ones? Creamies. Strawberry, raspberry, and carrot. Melts in baby's mouth. Dairy and gluten-free, 40% veggies. Curated for baby. Your child may be ready for this snack when they pull themselves up to stand with support. When they crawl without touching tummy on the ground. When they use jaws to mash food between gums and pick up food with thumb and forefinger. Finish the court story, sorry. It's really hard for me to talk while I'm streaming. Continue your story. Okay, I'm so sorry. So, on my ticket, it said that I needed to show up in court on or before the 7th, January 7th. So January 1st comes around, I'm like busy as hell. I'm just like, okay, I will show up on the 7th. Because it said I could show up on or before the 7th. Right? So I was like, all right, I'm just gonna go in on the 7th. The 6th comes around, I'm like, okay, I gotta go to court tomorrow. I go to look up the address. The 7th is a Saturday. They're closed on Saturday. So I was like, oh my God. One, why did they freaking tell me that I could be there on or before the 7th if I can't go on the 7th? So I was really mad. That fit perfectly and it was kind of sick. So I was really mad about that. And then I was like, great, now I have to go to court and I'm gonna have a late fee slash a warrant out for my arrest because I didn't show up on or before the 7th. So that was really stress inducing. This is my desk snack for the week. No way I'm gonna go through all this in a week, but that's okay. It'll last longer than a week. I'm going to put this in the studio and put a little bowl next to my desk. And I'm gonna refill the bowl so that when I'm sitting at my computer, I'm constantly eating healthy fats and these baby snacks, because they're also good for you. That is the plan with that one. So I was already late to court, which was stressing me out. Is the music too loud? No? Okay. So I was stressed about that. I went to court this morning. It was not nearly as scary as I thought it was going to be. I thought I was going to have to walk up. I thought I was going to have to talk to a judge. I didn't have to talk to a judge. But I think the reason that I didn't have to talk to a judge is because I went up to the clerk and she read my ticket and she was like, "Would you like to plead not guilty, guilty, or no contest?" And I was like, "Guilty." And so she was like, "All right, then you just have to sign this and pay." And I was like, "Oh, okay." You pled guilty, rookie mistake. I'm not trying to talk to a judge. Also, I am very guilty. How am I gonna not plead guilty to not having a Texas driver's license when I walked in there with a California driver's license? They asked for my ID. What am I supposed to say? What was your fine? Okay, so then it gets interesting, right? Is that it was $198. $198. And she said, "I had until the 16th to get a Texas license, but the earliest I could get an appointment to get my new driver's license is the 19th. So I have an appointment set for January 19th. But, and so she was like, "You could just get your license and come back and plead not guilty, because we could waive the fine from $198 to $93, and then it wouldn't be on your record." So if I were to go get my license, I could come back, say that I'm not guilty, talk to a judge, and potentially have $100 waived off of it and not have it on my record. But then I asked her, I was like, "But if I just pay the whole fine today, is it done with?" And she was like, "Yes." And I was like, "Here you go." Because, listen, the court was an hour away from me. And genuinely, my time in getting there and back is worth more than the $100 that it would be waived. And having on my record that I didn't have, that I had an out-of-state license for too long, truly just doesn't bother me. One, I don't need to get employed anytime soon. And two, like, that does not make me a delinquent. I don't really care. So I just paid for it. So yeah. I don't blame you, not worth it. Right. So now I have a criminal record. Okay, I made some pasta. Need a face chat now? Wow. Right. Grace Lacola is up for 5 months. Thank you. Wow. Guys, look. Grace, thank you for the sub. Anunnaki, thank you for the 2 months. Look at what Turka got me. Turka and Tanner got me this for Christmas. They got me a fancy knife. How cool is that? Sick.
500 bits. This just in, Twitch streamer Maya Hika seen fleeing courthouse on horseback. Chase is now commencing. Folks, this is the most bizarre chase I've ever walked up. Is that an emu? Where did those guts come from?
Thank you for the 2 months. Hello? Hello? Where are all my lids? Oh. Yako. Thank you. Oh my god, it's really sharp. Sick. I have to put so little pressure to cut. I know it's just a strawberry, but that's kind of sick. Mitch with the fro, thank you for the sub. Jail stream one. The other thing, I think it's because I expected for it to be really scary, but they were all really nice. Like, the officer when I walked in was super nice. Granted, it's probably because I looked very lost, because I was. I didn't understand how to get into the building or where I was supposed to go. I already look like I'm 14, and I default look scared, but I was actually scared. Damn, nice. They probably thought you were looking for your parents. Yeah, but he was really nice. Like, embarrassingly enough too, he knew I was so scared because I had to go in and like go through the metal detector where he was, and then he told me where to go, and when I was walking out, he was like, "Not so bad, huh?" And I was like, "No." So embarrassing. I didn't even indicate to him that I was stressed. Or like nervous, but I guess I just looked at. What I'm doing right now, it is meal prep, I guess. This is not a meal, but if you get produce, if you buy, I mean, you guys buy your groceries. When you buy your groceries, I highly, highly, highly recommend prepping your produce when you buy it, because when I buy produce in plastic like this, I have had a lot of fruit. Thank you for the 4 months. I've had a lot of fruit rot in these plastic containers. I don't know if it's because I don't want to like take it out and cut off the heads or just like eat it like that, or if it's I forget that they're in the containers. The underscore tricky underscore red resubbed for 13 months. Maya he corn, Maya he corn, Maya he corn, Maya he corn. Thank you. But when I prep my produce and I put it in like a nice jar, and it's all cut up, I've never had it go bad, because it's just like so inviting and I want to eat it that way. So you should try that. If you find your produce going bad, try prepping it first. Same with veggies. It's really nice and easy if you prep them and you can just throw them into whatever you're cooking instead of like not wanting to take it out and cut it up. I'm doing that last couple weeks. Helps a lot. Hooray! See, look how pretty. If you saw this in your fridge, doesn't it look more like a snack than like berries? In that, I did wash them, yeah. Where'd I put that other recycling? Oh, a ferret has it. Why is everything fitting so well? I don't know. Hi. Pinapinotage rolls. Resubbed for 2 months. I mean, there's nothing wrong with appreciating someone's work or their doings and preaching them for so. But trying to befriend them because of their status or name is what it is weird, especially thinking you know them just by spectating their life through their social / streams. What? Did I say something about something like that? What are they talking about? Thank you for the 2 months. Okay. pomegranates. Here's what I understand about cutting pomegranates. Cut off the top to where you can see all the segments, like that. And then you cut where there's breaks. Like this. I learned this from a pomegranate farmer on the central coast of California. You can also probably find this information on the WikiHow. So do like that, and then you should just be able to like open it, and then it's like in the segments that it's almost like an orange, you know? See how like they're all like, that's like a segment of pom, you know, like right here. So it's just a little easier to get them out. Is that a rat? Same with pomegranates. I go through pomegranates like nobody's business. My excuse for it, despite it being very laborious, is that they're really high in antioxidants. And I have cancer in my family, so I was just like, oh, like, I'll just eat pomegranates and I won't get cancer. But I also just really like them. But it is incredibly labor intensive. But I like putting them in a jar and eating them with a spoon while I sit on my horse. I love my life. These particular pomegranates are not organic. No. My fiance eats the shit out of those. Yeah, they're nice. I get it. Not organic. Yeah. Organic produce is good. I like organic produce. I buy a combination of organic and not organic produce. I listened to this, we gotta open up this conversation. I saw this TikTok the other day, and it was a guy talking about the animal Holocaust. And how if you compare, he was comparing the Holocaust to the animal agricultural industry, which you can probably imagine gets a lot of people talking and gets him a lot of attention. Which is interesting in the way that those girls throwing soup on that painting is interesting, right? And I should strain this pasta so it cools because I'm making pasta salad. So he was talking, he had some really good points. He made the comparison between like, if you put humans in the conditions that livestock are in animal agriculture, it may look like a concentration camp, which I actually do objectively agree with. But then he also made some crazy points. Like, he was like, humans are naturally herbivores. Put an apple and a rabbit in a baby's crib and tell me when the baby starts playing with the apple and eats the rabbit. And I was like, I've raised so much wildlife. If you put a seed and a lizard, a live lizard, in with a baby bird, it's not gonna know how to eat the lizard, you know? That's why the food is torn up for the baby. I think if you make the same example and you say like put like strips of rabbit, even if it's raw rabbit, right? Or strips of meat and apple in a baby's crib, they would probably eat both, you know? So I thought that was really unfair. But he did make some really interesting points that I actually liked a lot too. So I don't know. I guess it's a combination of that like shock factor that makes people really mad and the good points. Because if he didn't say any of that shock factor and he was just a really reasonable person, I would not have seen him on my For You page. A little food for thought. Put Tide Pods and an apple in a baby's crib, you'll see that the humans
That is so true. That's so true. The other thing, he was doing this interviewer, or he was doing this interview with an interviewer on the news, and she was saying how, like, well, lions, like, they eat zebras, and she was talking about this primal nature, and he was like, yes, but I also see you have a cell phone, and I see you have a computer, and I see you wearing glasses, and you don't get to pick and choose what qualities you hold primally when we're this developed and it's possible to be on a plant-based diet because of the developments that we have. Which I also actually think is a pretty fair rebuttal to when people are like, oh, it's just in our nature, you know? Because there are tons of people that live on plant-based diets that are alive and well, you know? He sounds like someone I wouldn't like. Sounds like someone I wouldn't like either. But it was interesting. I did all the skeleton work for a club in college. I was gonna found a club with some of my ag friends. I forget what the acronym was, but it was essentially like a conversation group to, I went to Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo. The interesting thing about our school is it's in a swing state or a swing county in California. So half of the students are like mega super liberal because they're Californian. And then half the students are very conservative Californian. There's a lot of conservative Californians.
And resubbed for 34 months.
Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you. And because it's on the Central Coast, Cal Poly got a lot of both of those things. So you get a lot of art students and a lot of vegans and a lot of vegetarians and a lot of ag students. And you got ag students that went into ag for sustainability, like myself, and you got ag students that were like redneck ag students, eat more beef ag students, you know? And that dichotomy on campus was crazy. Like, it was like a war. You would have ag students doing presentations and then vegan students protesting those presentations. We had barns on campus. Thank you for the sub. We had barns on campus Thank you. We have beef barns on campus and stuff like, and poultry on campus as well. Cal Poly raises poultry for Foster Farms. And the vegan clubs would protest at those campus barns. So it was just super interesting that those things both lived within that institution. So I had built a club as a conversation club to bridge the gap between those two because I hate that polarization. I talked about this last stream because it's just the least productive thing ever. It just makes both sides hate each other more and become more extreme on both sides. So I was gonna start a conversation club and I'm really glad that it didn't work out because it would have cost me a lot of stress and it would have been a mess, I imagine. Would have gotten into some really ugly conversations. Yeah, it was the Why Can't We All Be Friends Club. Centrist Mayo. That's why I dropped out of Cal Poly Democrats, actually. Cal Poly Dems watching this right now, fuming. It was just too far left for me. I couldn't do it. So I quit. But I was really involved. Like, I quit when they were...
500 bits. It's kinda rude to keep interrupting her with donos.
Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you. I was super involved in Cal Poly Democrats. I quit when they were asking me to be on the board. Like, I was gonna be a secretary. And then I was like, I'm out of here. I'm gonna strain this pasta. No, I'm not, actually. I might wanna use that pasta water. So I'm not gonna strain it. One more pomegranate. Oh, the pasta has soaked up most of that water. One more. It's Sorry if this part is boring for you. I get it. Big knife. Yeah. What are you cooking? The only thing that I have cooking so far was pasta. I'm gonna make a pasta salad. But right now I'm just prepping fruits. I have a screenshot of a DM from years ago. Maybe not years. Okay, when I was raising Tina, the red-tailed hawk. This is when I had my Instagram DMs open. Someone replied to my story. I put her eating mouse on my story, and it was like bloody, like, mouse. And they replied, what is he eating? ? And fruit was spelled F-R-O-O-T. Or no, there wasn't a question mark after fruit. That's why I thought it was funny. It was, what is he eating? ? Like, they thought it was like a strawberry or something. Like, they answered their own question, but they thought that she was eating fruit. That's still in my camera roll. And then I also have a screenshot of the first hate reply I ever received. It was on Reddit. Duh. It's on LSF. It was like... What was it? It was in 2019. Why is she so overhyped? She's like a 3 out of 10. Desperately trying to hide it with makeup. I think that's what it was. I would have to go look at exactly what it was. I remember the 3 out of 10. Definitely said 3 out of 10. And I remember reading it and being like, so it begins. I will tell you, like, being a normie, just starting to stream and seeing someone that you don't know say something about you on the internet when you don't know who it is a really weird feeling. I was like, kind of blown away. I was like, wow, that's so mean. It would probably ruin my day. I've definitely had days where comments ruin my day, yeah. Chat, just so you know, me saying that was not me asking you to rate me. You can stop. It's actually really weird. Whoa. That won't backfire? Yeah, well. Whatever. Bird out of 10. Nice. Rating is pretty toxic. I used to hate when guys did that in college. The guys that I was friends with. They're like, oh yeah, she's like an 8. What a weird... It's also like, it's so subjective. Like, why even do it?
I'm thinking about sharing some stuff for the show and tell.
Yay!
It isn't entirely conservation,
But it is animals, is that okay?
Yes, that is fine. That is fine. The hot list. What the hell? What the hell is the hot list? I had a boyfriend's friend rape me once in front of the boyfriend, and at first he was like, yo, what the fuck? And then somehow his friend convinced him that, like, it wasn't weird. And then he's like, oh, okay. I don't even know how that happened. God, what a different time. That friend told me that he had been in love with me for most of my relationship with that boyfriend after we had broken up. That about adds up. No, it's not someone that you know. God damn it. This was before I was a streamer. It's an L friend. You know what's confusing is the rate was not good. It was like a 6 or something. So it's very confusing. And it's the same. It's also the same one that said I was fat. The only guy that successfully made me think that I was overweight. Very confusing. Very confusing. How the hell? Said, quote, that photo makes your midsection not look very flattering, but you still look good. Something like that. I shouldn't have asked if it was a good picture. That's on me, honestly. All right. That is it. For the pomegranate. There's pomegranate everywhere. Why she's still in therapy? No. It's like a 1 out of 7 or 8 men. That's why I'm still in therapy. Thanks, Connor. Yeah. Alrighty. Cutting board. Wiping the cutting board off with a paper towel. Sure. Okay. Yeah, that's fair. I think that's a good way to go about it. That's fine. All right. Okay. Awfully brave of you to cut pomegranate with such bright clothes. True. Alright, now here's all the pomegranate seeds I have. It's just enough. Now I'm gonna put it in here without dropping any. Oh. 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 Oh, oh. No. I don't have a funnel. Just be patient. La 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 la. Oh! Oh no. My jar is full. Hold on. God, I'm crazy with the amounts today. Pomegranates. Whew. Okay. That's two pomegranates. Neat. There's one on the floor. Oh my God, there is. Clean. What are those good for? Eating. Okay. Think donk. Ooh. Connor's leucistic red-tailed hawk has an egg and is hatching. Go look at Window to Wildlife stream. Announcement post, but we don't have the pictures quite yet. Thank you for the bits. Bald eagle egg, the hawk just came to the nest. Oh, what the heck? Hexadrill sucked for the first time. I'm really proud of this. These are beautiful. I'm really excited to eat them. Okay. I go next to my blue moonlight skies. Okay. This pasta, cool. I'm gonna cut these tomatoes. Do they have to be spit out? No, you can eat the seeds. That would be so annoying if you had to spit out all the seeds. No, you can eat the seed. No! Sorry. Okay. Yay. Stop. Everybody stop. Everybody stop. Okay. I know it's kind of silly that I'm cutting them so small. I don't really like raw tomato. I do, but I don't like eating a lot of raw tomato. Yes, I'm putting it in the pomegranate bowl. It doesn't matter. It's going to be fine. For 26 months. Icy, thank you for the 26 months. I need to stop looking away from this knife because it is a sharp one and I'm going to cut myself. I'm making pasta salad right now. My pasta salad, I have to make a vinaigrette for it. Cross-contamination? Excuse me? This is all veggies. Who cares? It's barely going to taste like pomegranate. It's not that big of a deal. There's just a little bit of juice in the bowl. Sorry if I just triggered anyone. It's gonna be fine. So I'm going to make a vinaigrette for this pasta salad. I'm putting cherry tomatoes in it. I'm putting chickpeas. I'm putting mozzarella pearls. I'm going to make, look how beautiful these little tomatoes are. I wish I liked cherry tomatoes like as a snack. It is so beautiful. Unfortunately, I will throw up if I eat them as a snack. I don't know why. I just think about like raw tomato really grosses me out. But if it's eaten with other things, it's fine. What are mozzarella pearls? Exactly what it sounds like. Little balls of mozzarella. Guys, I had a conversation with my accountant today, or the other day, about what I could write off. I asked if I could write off my truck. And he was like, why? And I was like, because I use it as a studio space once a week. And he was like, okay, what are the business miles versus the non-business miles, and commute miles don't count? And I was like, never mind. He said, NT. And then I asked if I could write off my tiny house. And he asked why. And I said, because I use the kitchen as a studio space once a week. And I use the office as a streaming space. And he said that probably not. Not for the kitchen, because I use the kitchen for other things. And then not the office, because I probably use the office for other things. But I actually think I don't. I never do work at that PC. I literally only use that PC twice a week, and it's for this stream and my desktop stream. Otherwise, I only work at the LVS PC, or in this studio. So I actually am going to try to write off that square footage of the tiny house. Yeah, these tomatoes are getting cut so easily, and they're not. I'm not having to squish them to cut them, which is pretty sick. These little peppers. What the heck? 2 square feet. Actually, my streaming office is 8 by 8 feet. Oh my god! Don't say this is bad for women. Don't say that. See, now I feel like, now I'm actually pissed off. Okay. To make a vinaigrette for this pasta salad, I'm going to use a little bit of the oil from these peppers. Not that pepper. You, oh, both of you, what the fuck? Get out of there. And then some peppers. These are my peppers. I don't want to hear anything about the knife going in here. No one else is. None of y'all are eating these peppers, okay? Shut up. Get out of there. Okay. Excellent. It's managing. What else in here? Oh shit, do I have a can opener? I think I do. Yes. These are black olives, sliced black olives, to be precise. There's a little bit of olive juice in the vinaigrette as well. Olives in the pasta salad. Excellent. Why are you so mad? have nails. Okay, chickpeas. I gotta dump some of this juice out. It has to be outside because I don't want this going down my drain. Peach. I know you can use that juice as a thickener. I don't need it as a thickener at the moment. I'm so sorry. Mozzarella pearls. Thank you for the 2 months, little Drac. Look how cute. They look like mini marshmallows. They do. Rinse them? Why? There's no way I have to rinse these before using them. Who cares? It's only one guy saying to rinse the cheese. Why do I need to rinse the cheese? Because the pesticides on the cheese? How about you shut up? What the hell? What's wrong with you? Yes, you do. Read it. It's one guy. They will explode if you don't rinse them. What the hell is he talking about? It's dry, you need to rinse. This is not dry cheese. What the hell is he talking about? He's stressing me out. I'm not gonna rinse the mozzarella. Didn't you graduate from college? Okay, boys. Thank you. Yum. Okay. I need, I don't know if I actually want to put pickled onion. Yes, I do. I'm going to put spinach in here. Black Dot is gone. He disappeared. He got scared because you guys were bullying him. So he ran away. You should always wash your cheese to be sure. It was Appa.
Huge hit for Raven Resub for 29 months.
Huge.
Huge 2 slime Resub for 9 months.
Hug in the Raven, thank you. Gooch 2 slime. Thank you. Okay. Okay. So I need to make pickled onions. I don't actually remember how to do that. I know you have to cut an onion, and I know you have to boil apples. Do you think it's like... I would, if I was not using a recipe, which I'm probably not going to, I would just do half, or one part apple cider vinegar to one part water, and then like a few tablespoons of sugar. Does that sound accurate to y'all?
So up for is up for 9 months. Alvi's chia.
At least you don't look like Arthur. Dude. The amount of people that thought I was mad. Did you guys see that? It's not even just on LSF. It got Max put it on the TikTok. And people on TikTok are like, God, she has no sense of humor. And they're like, oh. And they're like, holy fuck, what happened to her? Like, imagine taking that seriously. Imagine being mad. Like, such thin skin. That is so embarrassing for them. Bro is pressed. I know. That, like, I don't understand how they can constantly call me Aubrey Plaza, and then when I do anything deadpan, they're like, oh my god, what a pussy. Why would I be mad about that? It's so weird. Alright. I'm gonna pickle half of this onion. In pieces like this. Small pieces. Beautiful. What a beautiful onion this is. Look at that. That is lovely. All right. Brace for loud noise. Never mind, not so bad. Okay. Pickling liquid. Apple cider vinegar. Like that much. I can't believe people take shots of this stuff. It smells like I think I would throw up. Water. Okay. I'm gonna start okay, let me transfer this pasta. I'm gonna reuse this pot to boil potatoes. Pasta. Pasta salad pasta. Test. Chad. Almost every dish is the same shade of pink. There's a lot of stuff in this house. It's... oh, God. Look, if I could dump this water down my sink, I would obviously be straining this. But I can't do that. because I don't have running water. And so my sink is just gray watering out right now, and it's gonna make my pipes smell. So that's why I'm doing it like this. But I am gonna dump the rest of this outside. Hold on. Hold. No, please. Oh. Peach. Okay. I got an estimate yesterday. My house is lifted. It's on wheels. It's technically classified as an RV. So it's raised off the ground, and you can see under it right now, which looks really trashy. Oh my god, bad news.
Wanted to give you the praise you deserve. All these other chatters think him cringe, but at the end of the day, I know what a real fan looks like, and that is me. We should come together on here instead of shaming each other. We are all brothers and sisters.
Classic. Is this complicated? It is. Thank you for the sub. Alright, I'm gonna put sugar in this pickling liquid. White sugar. Like 2 tablespoons-ish. So you got an estimate, thank you. sorry. My house, I got a message from someone the other day that I just like did not process because I was live. And I was like, how on earth did I not because I 2 hours later responded, like I did not know that information at all. And I look back and I was like, oh my god, I was live when I got it. I'm just incapable of I can't even finish a sentence or a story while I'm live, let alone like read a message and properly respond to it. So my house is raised and I need skirting around the sides of it so that you can't see underneath it. Ooh, it smells like vinegar. And I got an estimate yesterday to get the skirting done and a deck done. And the contractor was saying that decks made of wood, they last, but not nearly as long as they last, salt, thanks. Not nearly as long as, like, composite board lasts. This flaky salt is so beautiful. And so I was like, okay, well, but composite board is way more expensive. So I asked to get an estimate with the composite board. I was gonna get a deck across the whole front of my house. So that's 36 feet by 8 feet, which is a pretty significant deck. And I got the estimate back for all of the siding and the deck. Guess how much it is with the composite board, which composite board is like twice as much as wood. I have a composite deck, looks like trash, TBH. Oh. $24,000, $18,000, $60,000, $25,000, $30,000, $12,000, $15,000, $23,000. It was for... Wait, why am I... I'm, like, forgetting now. Hold on. I had it, and then you guys started saying numbers, and I forgot. Yeah, 19.5. So that's all that needs to be done for pickling liquid. And then you just let it cool down, put it in a jar, let the liquid cool in a jar, and then put the onions in there. So I asked for an estimate with wood instead, and hopefully it goes down half, because composite's supposed to be twice as much as wood is. Dude, all my jars are in commission. Oh my god, awful news, guys. Terrible news. I have to get a jar from... I had Connor put all my extra jars in this cabinet. This is... I can't... Don't put things higher than you can see, because you'll forget that they're there, and then they will mold. It's so sad. Damn it. Okay, okay. Oh, Connor! Oh my god. Fuck. Okay. Go. Nice fresh jar. Oh god. Donk. Donk. Wash it first? No, the lid was on and it was in a cabinet. Puppy molted. Puppy molted! Everybody! Puppy molted! Holy shit, puppy. So, okay, we have two scorpions. We have two baby emperor scorpions, and they're from the same clutch, so they're supposed to molt at the same time. And Tortellini molted weeks ago, and Puppy hadn't molted, and I was like, oh my god, he's gonna die. but he molted. And the first molt is the hardest for the babies to get through. So we're not in the clear, but like, that's really good. I saw a lemon in here. Let me see if it's still good. I doubt it is, because I don't even know when I put this in here. Huh? Yeah, it's fine. Any pickles update? No, she still hasn't come out. Pickles is still yet to molt. She's slow. Okay, I already juiced this lemon, so I don't know why I put it back in the fridge like a weirdo. Maybe, oh, I thought I was going to use the zest. Maybe. Perhaps. Why are you holding it up to it's like squirting in my eye. I don't like squirt. I don't like holding it down. Okay, forget it. I'm going to hold it down.
$10. Imagine living in a small house and still not being able to reach things.
Okay. When I juice them up, sometimes I can catch the seeds before they go in there. So that's why I did it like that, but then it went everywhere, so I changed my mind. Okay, I call that good. I'm making a vinaigrette right now for my pasta salad. So I'm thinking there's some pepper, canned pepper juice in here, lemon, a little bit of juice from a can of black olives, olive oil. It's not enough. It's a lot of pasta salad. Okay. And I'll do some Dijon mustard and some squeezed garlic. Oh, I forgot I had these. Artichoke hearts, yum. Hooray. My chat froze. What's wrong? Why are you guys freaking out? It's too late to apologize. IRL chat isn't responding. What about now? Now it's fine. Hello. What, did someone say something weird? Squeeze garlic, gross! I only chop fresh garlic when I cook for myself every day. Good for you! Mustard. Artichoke hearts, that's what I was gonna do. And then honey. Another tip. Put your condiments on the bottom shelf and stuff like cheeses higher up. I grew up putting my cheeses and dairies in like a drawer. I don't know why. It's just what my mom did. But then your cheese, you forget that it's in there and then it goes bad. And then you have constant access to condiments in your face, but you only use those like not even once a week. I don't know why that's a thing for fridges. I feel like that's for everyone though. But organize your fridge different. Okay, I'm gonna put these artichoke hearts in my pasta salad as well. I love artichoke hearts. Yummy. One more. One more. Okay, and then a little bit of the oil from the artichoke hearts in my vinaigrette. Okay, we'll put a pinch of salt in this vinaigrette. Maybe a little more. Maybe a little more. It's a lot of pasta salad. We'll do some honey in there. mix. I want to put pepper in here as well. Actually, I'm going to season this. Like with other stuff. Thank you for the 17 months. Hello. I'm going to use... Whoa. I'm going to put some onion powder in there. And that's all. Some onion powder. And black pepper. Okay. A little oregano. Yeah, okay. I have Italian seasoning, I'll just put that in there. My dad texted me about the keeping stream on Friday. He said, watching keeping stream, this was yesterday, I guess he watched the VOD yesterday. Watching keeping stream, camera is higher quality, wireless mic is better, can hear you when you step away from the camera. Thank you, Father. He's a VOD watcher. Alright, this is what we're looking at for the dressing. Sugar. Sugar. This is a lot of pasta salad. I always make so much more than I want to. Alright, let's see now. More. Did we do pasta salad last week? I don't think I've ever in my life made pasta salad, actually. Not even just meal prep. I don't even know how to make it. I'm just guessing. It's still so sour. I just put too much lemon in there. Pasta salad and dressing. Hold on. That'll do. That'll do. All right. Okay, let's chop these guys up. Artichoke hearts. Yummy. I love artichokes. I would do artichoke for meal prep, but I don't imagine that they reheat very well, do they? Have any of you done that? Nice. I'm actually really excited about these guys. No. Alright. So this is what we're looking at right now, pasta salad wise. We have pasta, black olives, cherry tomatoes, chickpeas, spinach, mozzarella, pearls, and artichoke hearts, and sweet pimento peppers. And then I'm going to put the dressing on it. It looks like pasta salad. Where's the beef? Beef and pasta salad would be really gross. You got a recipe link? I made it up. But you can watch the VOD. I think I said everything I was putting in. But not the amounts, though, because I don't know them. Sorry. Alright, what do you think? Yeah! I like it. I like it. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's really nice. Yeehaw. Okay. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. I give it like a 7. I actually like it a lot. How many days will that last you? That's I'm gonna have to give away some of that because that lasts me more than a week. Yo, thank you for the 23 months. Oh shit. Sad Thins, thank you. Gowdy, thank you for the $10. I don't think I saw that. I'll eat it, Connor. You can have some pasta salad. I'd eat that bowl all at once. That's crazy. That's gone in a day? Excuse me? What do you mean? This is so much, you guys. I don't think you could. 500 bits looks yummy. It's yummy and it's pretty good for you. It's not like particularly bad for you. Is this good for you? I feel like, it's all right. A light snack. Two days if I'm holding back. I feel like you guys are just trying to impress chat. This is a lot of food. Better than a burger? Okay, well, it's not saying much. I'm afraid. No, we're not. Are you guys being serious? I actually can't tell. You think you could eat this in two sittings? Four meals for sure. Huh. Okay, well that's fine. Like four? Definitely not. 3.18 sit. Okay, that's enough. Hey. Okay. And this gets boxed up for Connor. And or space. And or Kayla. And or Ella. A nutritious side for lunch. Chat is on crack. Certainly better than the macaroni pasta I made last week. That was bad for you. Space, I don't know if you would even like something like that. You definitely don't have to eat this. Don't worry about it. But Connor can have this tomorrow if he wants it. Connor, don't worry about bringing lunch tomorrow if you want this. But it had cheese. This has cheese. Space is starving. Dude, I always give Space food. Okay. This one's done. Red Bull and my food equals great. Launch. because everyone forgets to eat herself. Guys, when I made, it's actually kind of funny, when I made macaroni, I got so excited about feeding people macaroni. I gave Space a big bowl, or like a big container. I gave Ella a big bowl, and then I made a whole sheet pan for Caleb. And by the time I had fed everyone out of my macaroni dish, I had a fourth of it left on the same day. Pasta strawberry, but it's fine. So I finished the macaroni in a day. Or we collectively finished the macaroni in a day. Okay, I need this to not taste like artichoke heart right now. It's actually like a flip it over kind of situation. Because there's a lot that's gone on this board that I don't want my fruit to taste like. Because I'm going to put persimmon in the other ones. God. Feels great. Hooray! Oh my gosh, so sharp, scary.
Up for 25 months. Hot diggity dog 25 month roots.
They give it 25 months. Mm-hmm. Persimmon. Explain what this is. It's a persimmon. It tastes like an apple, if it was softer and creamier and tasted like fall. It like almost tastes cinnamony in a weird way. They're really good. Okay, check this out. A little pasta salad meal prep.
Wow. Salveki 24 is subbed for 16 months.
I made a thumbnail. For what? Nothing. Thank you for the 16 months, Salvakid. Yummy. One, two, three. I need another persimmon. The orange fruit is a persimmon. Did I just, I thought I had three persimmons. Where'd the other one go? Is it buried? Oh no, the sticker. Over there. Are you trolling? You ate it? Huh? Guys, I got a jewelry organizer. So now, look how sharp that knife is. Isn't that crazy? Look at this. I got a jewelry organizer, and prior to having an organizer, my jewelry was all in a, like a dish, in a dish, so I had no idea what was, like, what jewelry I had. Now, no! So sad. Now it's in this. Hold on. Now it's like that. So I can actually see all of it. And I know what jewelry I have, which is sick. And now I could wear my jewelry. Okay, actually, I'm gonna be honest, Stove, you're moving way too fast right now. Relax. Yay. So I can actually wear the jewelry that I have, which I'm really excited about. I wanna start accessorizing better so I can have more drip. Look. A viewer made me this necklace a while ago. They sent it to my P.O. box. It's very pretty. It has a little moon. And then I have these earrings that match. And that's it. Oh, sorry. All silver jewelry today. Yeehaw. Okay, heavy. All right, fridge. It's a pretty big kitchen. I did prioritize that. Your dad. Thank you for the 8 months. Mooth hooves. Thank you for the 6 months. Mashed potato time. Shoop waffles go in my junk cabinet. You guys want to tour my junk cabinet? I have a corner shelf that just has my junk food in it. Here's my Stroop waffles.
500 bits. I love tiny houses.
Me too. Thank you for the bits. I still have these caramel koalas from my Australian candy review. I also have some Mentos in here. Fruit Mentos. I have some holiday gummies. Rudolph gummies. I have a chocolate rabbit. And a candy cane. I have some chocolates with sea salt caramel and some fancy lollipops. They're elderflower lollipops. And then I have two Kinder Eggs and a Mr. Beast chocolate bar. That's it. That's the tour. I hope you enjoyed it. And then sometimes, I'll have a goldfish in there, but they're all gone for some reason. This is a big potato. Yeah, I'm gonna peel this potato and then, consider peeling the second one or not peeling it. Normally I wouldn't peel my potatoes for mashed potatoes because I don't care when mashed potatoes have skin in them. I am literally only doing this today because I don't have enough water to wash them. So that's why it's getting peeled. I actually also like the skin in mashed potatoes. I like a little rustic mashed potato, you know? Stay there. I prefer peeled. Is the skin good for you, or does it not matter? I feel like it doesn't matter with a potato. Okay, now you can boil. Go ahead. Boil. Boy, here's a little bit of salt for you.
Fry donated $5. Whatever was the outcome of the neighbors shooting guns in Elvia's direction while you guys spent the day in the trenches?
Thank you for the 11 months. It's a huge potato. This is one potato. Potato sandwich. A cop came out here and said that everything that they were doing was perfectly legal. And that was it. Classic. I heard a first grade teacher in Texas was shot by a 6-year-old student, like, this past week. Did you guys hear about that? Crazy, right? In Virginia. Yeesh. Not in Texas, in Virginia. But only she was shot. Yeah, she like yelled at her students to run away. She's crazy. West Virginia. Okay. Momo. What? Sorry. Okay, that's good. For those of you who are confused.
500 bits. Potatoes are vegetables, BTW. So delicious.
Oh, okay. So Alveus has two new ambassadors. They're marmosets. There's a black tufted marmoset and a common marmoset. Their names are Momo and Appa. They came with a list of health problems because they came from a neglect situation where their owners didn't know how to take care of them or couldn't take care of them, so they were surrendered to our vet. Now we have them. They're being critically monitored and they're on medication, which is why they're in my tiny house, because they're getting calcium supplements twice a day. They have metabolic bone disease. One of them is pretty much not unable to use his back legs, but he has severe muscular atrophy from his middle of his spine down. And then one of them also has major issues with his teeth, so he's having to get teeth pulled. And they're both malnourished, so they need to gain weight. That's why they're inside. The other reason they're inside is because Alveus doesn't have the USDA permits right now to have them in an enclosure outside. But as a Texas resident, I can have them as my pet with absolutely no permits, which is incredibly backwards, especially given their situation and where they come from. But it works out because they need to be monitored and they need meds twice a day, so they should be inside anyway. They also are Brazilian monkeys, so their temperature range is really narrow. They can only, it's like high 60s to like mid 80s or something that they can handle. So we need to build them a room outside that's completely climate controlled. It has to have AC and heating. And so they couldn't be outside anyway. So that's why they're in here. I'm not showing them to you yet because they came from a really, really bad pet trade situation, and I want to be very careful about how they're presented at Alveus. I don't want people to see them and think, oh my gosh, pet monkey, really cute. So you'll see more of them once they're outside in their enclosure and they present more like a zoo animal, but for now, you'll just see them in pictures. They're on the Alveus socials. There are pictures of them up. I also tweeted it yesterday. So if you want to see pictures of them, they're on Twitter. You can link them if you want. If you want to see what they look like, they're about this big. They're marmosets. They're really, really little primates, but they're really cute. But you'll see more of them once they're outside on stream, and then we're making a YouTube video right now of their recovery process. You'll see that whole thing as well. Sorry, it's kind of a long explanation, but it's a necessary one. Okay. It's gonna be a good video. Should be an interesting one for sure, yeah. Alright, this pickling liquid is ready to be poured over my onions. What do you think about this?
People
pop, wow! Plus score is up for 43 months. Yo.
That went fine. Pizza, thank you for the 43 months. Okay, so once these onions are pickled, I will put them over. That's plenty of pickling liquid for these onions. Oops. I think I should just cut up the rest of this onion. Because that's so much liquid, I don't need that much. I'm gonna cut up the rest of this onion. Then I'm gonna have way too many pickled onions, but that's okay. Who eats that? Me. None of the animals. These need to pickle at least overnight, but they're the best after like probably 48 hours or so. And I will put them on top of my pasta salad. That ratio of liquid to onions makes a little more sense. For those curious or that weren't here when I made this liquid, it's just equal parts apple cider vinegar and water and like 2.5 tablespoons of sugar and a pinch of salt. Big pinch of salt. And then you let it cool down and you pour it over whatever you want to pickle. These will turn, you guys have seen pickled onions if you've bought them on like in a restaurant, they turn like really like pink, like bright pink almost overnight. But this is what they look like to start.
500 bits, onions and garlic prevent vampires.
Oh yeah. Sick. Okay, I'm gonna, oh, do I not have? Oh, yes, I do. Well. Okay. This is gonna be annoying. A pinch of ginger in pickled onions. That is a good idea. Okay. So, I did a bit of an experiment when I made smoothies last time, and I used coconut chunks, like frozen coconut chunks. Don't do that. They don't blend. Okay? Did she put the hot onions in the fridge? No, it's completely cooled down. So I'm gonna take all my smoothie stuff and take the coconut out. But it's like too fibrous to blend, so don't do that. Okay, what's it all coming out? It's kind of cringe. I need more spinach. I feel like with the brie situation that I'm gonna do and this mashed potato situation, not a lot of veggies going on. So I'm gonna make like really spinach heavy smoothies for this week. Teddy's, thank you for the sub. So smoothies in the morning, it'll just be this frozen fruit, which is mangoes, peaches, bananas, spinach, and then Greek yogurt without these coconut chunks. What's in the microwave? Nothing. Shredded coconut and bulk up. Weird, I thought I had so much more frozen fruit. I don't have like any, but I have to put some of my strawberries in there. Okay, not that many. Spinach. Anyone can cook. That's a lot of berries. Yeah, it was a lot of strawberries. Okay, two smoothie bowls. Prepped. In the freezer. Excellent, excellent. Okay, I need to go up to my loft to get my tinfoil. Why is there tinfoil in your lawn? I had to soak my nails in acetone, or in cotton balls that had acetone on them, and then wrap them in foil so that they'd come off. And I left the foil up there. Hold on. To make a hat, right? Ugh! Oh, of course it's all the way in the back. Come here, foil. Okay. Thank you. Huh. Okay. Hello. Thank you for continuing your gifted sub. Hooray. So then, I'm gonna prep some baked brie. How long do potatoes, I have no idea. I need like a fork. Fork test. Oh shit, what the hell? That was way faster than I expected. No. Go back. Okay, if you're making mashed potatoes, does it really matter if they're overcooked? Like, does it really matter? Woo! Always overcook them. Okay, so this is like extremely bougie what I'm doing. Don't do it if you don't want to be extremely bougie. I'm gonna prep some baked brie. I love brie, it's very fancy. This brie, like this block, is $4.52, which is a lot, I feel. So I'm putting this in the center. I'm going to cut some slits in it like this so that it gets really like oozy goozy. I found figs, which I am stoked about. This one is rotten, I want to cry. This one's fine. Thank you for the 13 months, Sly Ninja. So I'm gonna cut these figs. Oh God, they're so beautiful. Look. Amazing. I'm gonna do honey. On top of this brie. It's a lot of cheese, okay? Don't worry about how much honey is going on it. And then put these figs on top of it. And then, actually, I'm gonna get a little crazy. I have this fig spread. You guys have to be done now. Come here. Come here. Yes. Okay, they are done. I'm gonna be crazy. I have this cute little fig spread. I got this in like a gift basket thing. It's a sweet and spicy cheese and meat pairing. Maybe I'm not using this. That doesn't help. Gee, okay. Sick. Sick! Okay. I'm gonna put fig spread on it. Because I like when it's sweeter out of the oven. Okay. Some fig spread, amazing. Then the figs. Get over there. You get over here. And then. Where are my frickin' walnuts? What the heck? What the heck? Oh my God. I'm blind. Okay, and then walnuts. Okay, and then a little bit of flaky salt. All right. Woo. And this is it. I will wrap this, and then when I want to eat baked brie, I will unwrap it and put it in a baking dish at 350 until it's like really melty. And then I bought a baguette, and then you just like dip the baguette in there. This one, not particularly good for you, but it'll taste really good. So there's one baked brie. Go in there. We'll do another baked brie. Same thing. Can you eat the rind? I prefer not to, but I think you can. I just kind of eat around it. Also, someone asked if the cheese is warm. It's not. It's just been out of the fridge for a while. Like since I started the stream. So it gets kind of squishy. Not rhyme, rind. Okay. Score. Do you want the music louder? No. Could be louder. Okay. Yum. Okay, I'm just gonna use the rest of this. It's a very little drawer. Very nice, boys. Thank you. There's music. Yes. A little bit of this, a little bit of this. I'm not gonna put honey on this one because I put so much preserve. Is she talking to us? No, I was talking to the monkeys. A little bit of this, a little bit of this, a little bit of flaky salt. A lot of flaky salt. Done. They last the whole week. Potato and gravy time. Gravy time, and then mashed potatoes. I want to eat this fig. Thank you for the sub. The guy. Check this out. Fig. This one sucks. That's a bad fig. Peck. Let's try this one. Sad. This one looks a little more ripe.
Wow.
An anonymous user gifted a tier 1 sub to Fig.
That one's much better. Fig. Tastes like flaky salt. Because there's flaky salt on the cutting board. Yep. Alrighty. So, for gravy, typically, you would make like a meat and then start with the drippings, right? But I don't have that. I don't have drippings. So I'm just gonna start from scratch. I'm gonna use onion and mushrooms and stock. And that'll be it. No drip, sad. Mushrooms, not my ferret. Silly gooses.
Wow.
Marian 7 resubbed for 5 months. Hello.
Thank you for the 5 months. Hello. Alright, we've made pretty healthy things so far. It's about to get a lot less healthy, I'm afraid. Hooray! Less healthy. A little yellow onion. Alrighty. I need a gravy pot. Should I use a wok for this? Is that crazy? I feel like it just has the depth that I need. You know? It'll be fine. Of course it's pink.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so to make gravy, I'm going to put butter in that pan, and then I'm going to cook the onions down, and I'm going to add flour. I'm going to make a roux. I'm going to let it darken up a little bit, and then I'm going to add mushrooms. And then I'm going to add some heavy cream, and I'm going to add some vegetable stock. That's going to be it. Let me see if this second cam works. Hi, second cam. All right, so you all kind of see what's going on in there. Butter. I'm gonna use like half a stick of butter in here. Nobody panic. I realize that's a lot of butter, but I'm making gravy, so I need it. Yum. Might leak a monkey. No. They're way on the other side of my living room. Alrighty. Whoa, it's already happening. Okay, let the onions go with the butter for a bit. I'm going to strain these potatoes outside. Your oven has pink lights. What? My stove has pink lights? What do you mean pink lights? My stove is a mess. Ow! Ow! Ow!
500 bits.
Hot. Hot. It's all flaky salt. Oh shit. The burner color. Oh, interesting. Ow! Okay. I need to strain these potatoes out. Actually, I don't know how I'm gonna do that because I can't just like put that on the ground outside because that's gross. I think I'm gonna put the potatoes. On the cutting board and then dump the water outside and then put the potatoes back. It's fine. It's fine. The sink? I don't want to talk about it. Okay. Alright. It's happening. It's getting done. What needs to get done is it's getting done. Okay. Here. Now. Okay. Here. Okay. Now I need to take this outside. Okay. Come here. I'll be back. Hold on. No, please. Oh my god. Okay. Whatever. Ugh! Woo! I'm a little bit all over the place, I will admit. Oh my god. It's fine. Nobody panic. Amazing. Okay. Onions getting a little bit translucent, just a little bit. Gonna add the potatoes back into the pot. Beautiful. I'm gonna cut up my mushrooms. I might not even use those. I have these oyster mushrooms. They're baby king oyster mushrooms, which is a weird thing to put in gravy, but I wanna use them. I got these new mushrooms, but I might as well not use those and use these because they're gonna go bad soon. They were bought before. So I bought Bella's to put in gravy, but this will have to do for today. As to not waste food. I'm actually gonna start cooking these with the onion before I make the roux, I think. I really like these a lot. King oyster mushrooms are really good. Bella Smokey. Alright, let's see. Alrighty. It smells really good. actually going to use the other stick, or the other half of this butter stick for my mashed potatoes. In moderation. You know? How about some spinach in the mac? That's actually a good idea. I've never done that. Should I do that? I'm not gonna put heavy cream in this gravy, but I am gonna put it in the potatoes. Yes. Do it. I don't see why not. I don't have any chives, but that would be sick. Okay, let's mash these and see where we're at. Then I will consider adding more liquid, which in this case would be milk, but actually I think it's looking like that was plenty, maybe even too much. Thank you for the 2 months. Yep, no more liquid. I don't have an immersion blender, and I am not going to put it in a blender. I'm just going to have a little bit chunky mashed potatoes, and that's okay. I feel like that's not nice. That's a really weird thing to say. I don't really like that you said that. What the hell does that mean? Chocolate chips. I'm not using those. I just need to move them to get to my flour. Oh my goodness. Woo! Start with that. Let's see. See where we're at. So, add butter and flour, and you get roux. A roux. I'll let this cook for a little bit. Get a little darker so that there's a little more flavor. It's looking really dry right now, but we are going to add some vegetable stock once it cooks down some. Okay? Okay, taking the deck from the composite material to wood takes it from 19.5K to 11.5K, which I actually think is pretty reasonable considering the how large of a deck I'm building. So I'll probably do that. I could build that for $500. What do you guys think about the start of this gravy? Okay, let's give the mashed potatoes a little more attention. Big pinch of salt. Some squeezed garlic. Squeezed garlic. Where are you? Oh. Some pepper. How much for wood? 11.5. Wood, no. Sorry. It's not 11.5. It's 11.5 for the wood deck and all the siding around the house. The wood deck, 36 by 8, is 9.7. I put too much liquid in these potatoes. more color on the roux. Actually, that'll do it. I'm gonna put some stock in here now, see what it looks like. Add some whole milk if I need to. It's not looking rich enough. I thought I had stock. Or like an open one? Do I not? I always buy stock. I always have so much and I forget that I have it every time. Maybe, actually no, I used it all for my egg drop soup, huh? Ah! Here's one. But I don't think it's open. Stock. A little dramatic. I'm going to add a splash of whole milk to this. Just a splash. Just a splash.
SHQ donated $5. Who doesn't like guacamole?
Okay. Thank you. That was more like a sploosh. Sorry. All right. It's looking good. Looking very light, though. Do a nice heaping pinch of flaky salt. A lot of pepper. Stock. Okay, that looks better. What do you guys think? Some mushroom gravy, some mashy potato. Whoa, that's a lot of garlic. Taste test. Ooh, yum. I suppose it could have been worse. I suppose this could have been worse. Shit. Shit. All right. Stovetops off. Everybody relax. It's a taste test time. Ew. Heck. T- taste test time. Ew, the bowl's gross. It's just mashed potatoes and gravy on top of it. It's terrible for you. But, like, it's fine. Oh, I was gonna put spinach in the frick. Okay, I'll put spinach in them in a second. The mashed potatoes are a lot more garlicky than I expected them to be, but it's kind of nice because it's super garlic, super savory, and there's so much onion in the gravy. It made the gravy pretty sweet, but not in a gross way, and like a really rich, like caramelly way. So I actually like them together a lot. The mashed potatoes are too thin. I added too much heavy cream to mashed potatoes. But you live and you learn, you know? I'm just like, what the hell are you doing? Fair. It has to be done. I don't have enough veggies in this week. I know it looks crazy right now, but the spinach is gonna wilt down into nothing, and then it'll be like, oh, it's fine. Don't worry. Just give it a minute. That is awful for you. I like the balance. I like the mostly healthy stuff, and then the one just like horrible thing. That's pretty good. £100 dream. I freaking zoomed through that today. Wowee. I guess there wasn't a lot of cooking today. Just a lot of like prepping. A weigh-in. Shall we? Okay, I'm being honest right now, this is 106.8. I have never weighed that much in my life. I don't know if that's right. It's on flat ground, hold on. Oh my God, please, oh no. Get off this mat. It shouldn't matter though. This is 105.8. Dude, that's the most I've ever weighed. I think ever. That's actually sick. I feel like, I don't know at what point you start to tell that you weigh more or less, but like, generally I weigh like 98 pounds. Don't you think at 105 you'd be able to kind of tell? Or like 10 pounds up you'd be able to tell? Or no? Because I don't feel like I noticed. No? Oh. you weigh 100 pounds, yes. With how small you are, maybe. I can't tell. I don't really want to ask this question, but, like, can you guys tell? I feel like I look the same. Do I not look the same? You look the same? I'm live.
Oh, perfect.
On my actual channel.
Did you ever dream I died?
No.
Oh. That's what I was worried about when I woke up and I saw your text.
Oh, sorry. No. I did have a really fucked up dream I was going to tell you about. That's why I texted you when I woke up.
Oh, okay. That's funny. I knew it was about a dream. I'm a mind reader.
That's because I texted you at like 5 a.m. your time.
Well, also, you could have, like, heard a scary noise outside and you need to talk to somebody.
No.
Oh, okay.
It was a crazy dream, and it stems from trauma, and I think it's really interesting, and I wanted to tell you about it.
Cool, exciting.
Yeah.
I just had therapy, and my therapist said, we've got to target the negative perpetrator that lives in your brain. And I said, that's cringe.
That's not cringe, that's fair. It's nice to separate those things.
Where are you supposed to live then?
Somewhere else, not in your brain.
Yeah, because I've convinced myself, because I was supposed to go to Japan in February, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I've convinced myself that if I go, I'll die.
Right. Well, that's for every plane ride, though.
Yeah, it's every plane ride. But I'm also, like, stressed because I have Stream Awards in March, and so if I die, it's like, well, what the heck?
There are bigger problems than Stream Awards if you die.
Well, no, that'd be super frustrating.
But you're not gonna die.
Well, I barely had an epiphany today that the reason I feel like when good things happen, bad things are gonna happen, is because my dumbass parents took us to Disney World and then brought us home and got divorced.
That's interesting.
I was fucked up of them.
That's a really interesting thought.
I was like so pissed when I realized. I was like, God damn it. She was like, think about that 8-year-old during the divorce. I was like, no, she's cringe.
I hate when my therapist asks me to think about me as a baby and that, because I cry.
Yeah, me too. Every time. I'm like, I feel bad for that dumb bitch.
Right, Sam. That was the first time I cried in the MDR. She was like, imagine yourself. But as a 12-year-old girl thinking what you thought, I cried.
Yeah.
That's a tough one.
Yeah. Anyway, that's all.
I'll call you later to tell you about the trauma dream. It's actually crazy. It's actually super fucked up. I'm really mad about it.
I can't wait to hear you whine about it.
Wait, that's a sick concept. We should do calls on stream where we should talk on stream about and complain about things. And we call it whine about it.
I literally hate you. I hate you.
I'll call you later.
Bye.
Okay, bye. Ow. If that was off stream, she would have told me something else. I know you wanna cry all night. Dogging in your sleep. Is fucked up dream the one about my Twitter account? No. No, it's much worse than that. It's actually ideal wine about it content, to be honest. But I'm not gonna talk about it because you guys would get cringe. I'm not trying to turn my chat cringe, sabotage myself like that. Too late. That's okay. Hello, everybody. Welcome to my meal prep stream. I'm done cooking. So I'm kind of, like, cleaning up right now. I'm going to package this stuff up. The veggie stock away. Put these in a container. Mashed potato container. What's wrong? F. Dropped a frame. I did that as a little tomfoolery. It was just a little joke. Question. Should I just put the gravy on top of this in the fridge, or is that gross? Should I package the gravy separately? Don't do that. Okay. Separate. All right. Sure. Fair. That's fair. In my mashed potatoes. Here's my gravy. Yummy. This does not get to go in the fridge yet. It is too hot. The mashed potatoes can go in the fridge. It'll get soggy. Okay, they're separate. Do not worry. This feels like a problem for me tomorrow. Not for today. Oh, actually, I should start putting this in here. Future Maya can deal with me. This is my dirty dishes to take to the nut house container. Pretty fun. I love hiking my dirty dishes all the way down to the nut house. Okay. Wednesday? I think I'm gonna do a, I need to make more bags for homeless people. I'm out. I just ran out. I don't have any in my truck right now. So I think I'm gonna do one of those streams where I put them all together. So I need to go pick up stuff for them tomorrow or Tuesday. Are you guys cool with me doing that instead of a car stream? You still go to a shelter on Tuesdays? Dude, I haven't gone in so long. It's actually really sad. Oh, it's just so hard because they start it. The shift start at, what are they, 5? 5 a.m.? Yeah, it's 5 to 7 a.m., which is just, it's just so hard to do. And to come back and do a full day of work because I haven't had a day off to do it. Oh, no, I need to get back to it. And I live out in the middle of nowhere, right, and that, the volunteering I was doing is downtown. I don't live close to downtown. So, it's a tough one. But I will do the bags. We'll do the bags. Hello, ferret. Pooge. I miss the truck streams. Are you axing the car streams? No. I just don't want to do them every week. The thing about Wednesday is my, like, anything slot, you know? So, like, Animal Quest, P.O. Box, car stream, doing these things. If I do a different IRL. You did one so far? And what about it? That's what I just said. I'm not doing car streams every week. Wednesday's a variety day. I don't get it with the car thing. People get so attached to the car streams, I don't get it. Do car streams every day! But the car. I will do more car streams, but only if I don't have something else to do on a Wednesday. It's kind of like a filler thing, you know? Gotta save one spot for the switch up. I just want art streams back. Oof. That, I'm gonna tell you, you should not look forward to, because I won't do those, probably. Actually, I don't know if I'll ever do I can't put these here, because the ferrets are gonna come get it. It's hot. No. Art streams are so comfy. They're comfy and they just kill viewership. People get too bored too fast. You know? The mural. The mural is probably something I want to finish on LBS. That was a tough one too. In all my free time, I can finish the freaking mural. Twizzlers, thank you for the 17 months. Second channel art stream? No. I basically have a second channel. Gun range? Dude. I'm scared to stream at the gun range for lots of reasons. I'm scared doing IRLs in public because I'm scared someone's gonna snipe me and kill me. And I don't know if I could handle the anxiety. I've thought about this. I don't know if I could handle the anxiety at being at gun range, knowing that like they could find like what range I was at, or if it like leaked or something. I'd be so scared, like the whole time, of one of the people shooting just being a sniper. I don't think I could do it. A literal sniper. So yeah, I don't know. When I made that goal, that was not a fear that I had. I don't know if I was more naive or if things have gotten worse. I think it's a little bit of both. But I'm sorry. Hello, mushy room. Clean. Bug catching and microscope, that's a really good Wednesday one. Ella and I were gonna do that. I don't know what happened to that. Well, no, I do know what happened to that, actually. We were gonna do it right before November. So then we couldn't do it. I got a new pair of pants and I'm unsure about it. You guys wanna see them? Now that we're stalling until 3 p.m. We got 30 more minutes until we raid into Ella. For Minecraft Monday. They were 50% off. They make me look like a businesswoman. But I actually think they're cool. Hold on. I think they're really nice. And you wear them with like, you like dress them down with some platforms or something. Here, I'll show you. Stay here with the music.
Jeez. What do you think?
Fancy? Very CEO-like? Good pants? Okay, I know they look super like business formal. I'll turn the cam off, sorry. But I feel like they can be dressed down to be really cute and like not that formal. You know? I'd like them with a belt. They fit so well though, which is unusual. Maybe it's because I gained 10 pounds. I'm gonna go around telling people I gained 10 pounds. Should I tell my mom?
Hi, Maya.
Hi, I'm live.
I'm practicing my TEDx talk.
You're doing a TEDx talk?
Yeah, at Mountain View High School.
Whoa, cool.
I don't know if it's going to be cool, but why are you live and what do you need?
I'm live because I'm doing a keeping stream. I'm not doing a keeping stream. I'm doing a meal prep stream. But I gained 10 pounds.
Good job.
Thank you. I now weigh 105 pounds.
Very good, Maya. You need to weigh over 100. That's terrific.
Thank you. That's all.
That's all? That's why you were calling me to tell me you've gained some weight?
Yep.
Good job. I will call you when I lose some weight. How about that?
Okay, we can swap.
Okay. Love you, sweetheart.
Okay, I love you too.
Okay, bye, honey.
Bye. My mom doesn't need to lose weight. It's crazy. Why do I have 12 new messages? Holy moly, donut shop. Okay, whoops. Little miscommunication today. Need to make a call. Need to make a call soon. Space, I think you got paid twice. You check your bank account. That's okay. We'll sort that out. We will sort that out. No big deal. easy. He does deserve it. He does deserve it. That's so true. That's so true. I think that's great communication. Okay. That was fair. That is fair. What else do I have to talk about? I feel like nothing. I feel like I literally have nothing else to do. Maybe I should just ask Ella if she's ready. Should I just ask Ella if she's ready? Early? Ella. You be able to start early. I am pretty much done up here. If not, I can stall. No problem. It was a little actually. We'll see if it's a little bit of a problem. Random conspiracy theory. What? I watched Big Hero 6 yesterday, which is not new. So if I spoil anything, I don't want to hear it, okay? It's old. If you haven't seen it, it's your fault. Does anybody else get annoyed in movies when they don't kill the bad guy because of some moral thing where they're like, you don't want to do that? And they're like, no, that's not you. And then they prevent them from killing the bad guy? In... like Batman too. Almost always. F that. Kill him. Okay. That's what I'm saying. I think it's so annoying when there's a very clear bad guy and they're like, no, I won't kill you. Like, I'm too good. The good thing would probably be to prevent them from doing more bad things. I don't know. That's just me. I don't want anybody to take that and spiral and make some some opinions in their head about my statement on some sensitive matters. I'm just saying in movies, if it's very clear and they're a freaking bad guy with superpowers that are blowing up whole buildings and ending lives, that you should probably just kill them because they're a bad guy and they should go away. You know? Anyway, look how cute my hair clip is. Oh. Look at how cute it is. Isn't that cool? It has little flowers on it. Little flower beads. Ella's ready! Okay, folks. Here's what's gonna happen. Here's what, my phone app says I have 1.7k viewers. Here's what's gonna happen. I'm going to raid. Here's what happens every week. Every week, every time I do a stream, I raid into Alveus and something is happening on the Alveus channel. Even on Thursdays. Thursday's the nightlife cam, something's molting, something's pooping, something is having intercourse. The insects, I mean. Every stream, I raid Alveus, and on Mondays, I raid into Minecraft Monday. Ella is playing Minecraft today. And you need to go watch her play Minecraft. It's a very cozy stream. She's one of the top Minecraft streamers on Twitch, literally. And she's incredible at it. And she's building Alveus, and it's very important. So, it's Minecraft Monday time. You're gonna raid into Ella. I'm gonna work on enrichment. I'm gonna have a sit. I'll sit for like 7 to 10 minutes, and then I will go make enrichment. And, that'll be it. I might see you on that stream a little bit. And if I don't see you on the Alveus channel later today, because I'm always on that channel, you gotta follow Alveus. There are streams on there all the freaking time. Then I will probably see you on the Alveus channel tomorrow at some point. Just press start streaming and you'll be good to go. All right. See you guys on Wednesday. Follow the Alveus stream, go watch Minecraft Monday. Hooray!